was not a band situation ever. I think not on any track on the record. It was always, looked at it more of like an audio sculpture, not to sound pretentious, but every track we'd try to take a new approach. And some of them were loop based, which would be more dance oriented. A lot of them though started with maybe just a sound, and that evoked some place that then we'd start constructing things around it. We used the computer to record into, but rather than use samplers and synthesizers as I would use to grab for immediately, this time, if there was a line or a melody line or something I had in my head, instead of picking up the same keyboard I would have always used, I'd make myself try to play it on an instrument I didn't know how to play, and then process it and sample it. With the kind of techno revolution is, to me, probably more affecting than the punk revolution was. If you liken the two, punk said that you don't have to be Emerson, Lake, and Palmer and study guitar for 30 years and how to do crazy things to be a musician. Pick something up, if you have something to say, express it. And I think that brought a whole wave of new energy to the scene. And a lot of it was crap, but there were some good things that came out of it. But when drum machines and computers and technology became cheap, and now anybody for a couple hundred dollars can make a record that sounds as good as anybody else's in their bedroom, I think the same kind of revolution is taking place, and a lot of it is crap. Just because you can make a record that sounds good doesn't mean you have anything to say. Like when I first heard drum and bass in Jungle, I was blown away by the different juxtapositions of a kind of half beat reggae, halftime reggae over double time break beats, and really cool cultural collision of sound. And then after the 400th record that adheres to this real strict formula, it has to be this BPM, has to sound like this, has to have this sample. That's what I find real limiting about the general electronic scene in general. As far as the snobbery of maybe rock musicians that don't think electronics is real, let them think that. No one cares. I've studied music and I'm a trained musician, but Atari Teenage Riot is probably one of my favorite bands because it says something. It says a hell of a lot more to me than Matchbox 20 does. Bow down before I'm the one you serve. You're going to get what temper this, because my knee-jerk reaction to Fragile now is to make a stripped-down, four-track, all-electronic record. But that really, I doubt, is the truest thing I could do. I mean, if it was an EP or an experiment, that's one thing. But to do something just to be a contradiction to something else, I think I have to let this idea destiny for a while. Moby having the courage to make a record that's an interesting album, but it's not easily classified into a disc, you know? I think there needs to be bands that define genres, but I hope to never be one. I just do what I think is interesting to me, and I try to... I really don't believe that I'm trying to follow the trend and act hip like I know about this and that and see I'm still cool, I've been around for a while. It's just I'm trying to do what appeals to me and challenges me as a musician and has some depth to it, and that's what I think I've generally lacked, and definitely in the American scene.